Dirtle Magic. Thank you for tuning in to Dirtle Magic. Please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you like the content you see here today, and leave a like and share the video with someone you might think is interested. Leaving those likes really helps us out, but another way to help us out is by using our TCG Player affiliate link below. If you're looking for a single, sealed product, or gaming accessories, please consider using our link to support the channel. We also have some playmats at inkgaming.com. Go ahead and hit the link in the description to check those out. Alright, let's grab some spells and dirtle with some magic. Hello and welcome back to Dirtle Magic. Today we have the deck tech for Kardur, the Doomscourge. Let's get some super code going and take a look at the deck. If we go ahead and take a look at Kardur Doomscourge, it's a 2 black red legendary 4/3 Demon Berserker. When it enters the battlefield, until your next turn, creatures your opponents control attack each turn if able, and attack a player other than you if able. Whenever an attacking creature dies, each opponent loses 1 life and we gain 1 life. This deck will focus largely on trying to abuse the commander. It does have some extra goad in it and some ways we can get around defenses and stuff. Let's go ahead and take a look. The categories we're going to cover for the deck today are Super Goated, Battle Again, Lava Fields, and Break Their Lines. Alright, let's go see what we have in store for the goad mechanic. First up is Super Goated. While goad is a regular mechanic and it's a great mechanic, our commander does it a little bit better, but let's see what cards may aid him in his endeavor. First up, we have a few creatures that just straight up do goad. Agitator Ant is one of those creatures. An opponent can elect to have 2/1/1 counters put on one of their creatures, and then that creature has to attack somebody other than you if able. Geode Ranger, for just a lane fall, allows us to assign goad to all the creatures as target player controls. Then we have Conjurer's Closet, which can help blink our commander if we have any other good enter the battlefield effects. Disrupt Decorum makes all the creatures get goaded for one turn, and if you have a way to recur it, that could be a way to keep creatures off of you and away from your face. Then we have Grenzo Havoc Razor. Whenever any of our creatures hit an opponent, we can goad a target creature they control. It also has the other upside of if we can't goad any of their creatures for whatever reason, we can exile a top card and possibly cast it ourselves from their own deck. What good is goading our opponents only once when we can do it again? Forcing everything to clash repeatedly is a good way to keep the board under control of the creatures anyway, and we can abuse our commander to achieve that end. Our commander, however, has better than goad as its ability, so let's try to abuse that a little with Hellkite Courser. When it comes into play, we can cast our commander from the command zone for free. It does go back there, though. Porphyro's Bronze Blood gives all of our creatures haste, plus we get a sneak attack-like effect for red and or artifact creatures. Recur our commander to our hand, play it as a discount, get that ETB. Phyrexian Reclamation and Haunted Crossroads can keep bringing our commander back to our hand or the top of the deck, and then Chainer, Nightmare Adept, we can just discard a card to the graveyard to cast our commander from the graveyard. A lot of these are to get around that commander tax because we really want to keep abusing that ETB on our commander. Of course, another way just to bring back our commander or any creatures that may be dying in combat to our side of the battlefield are these, of course, classic enchantments by now. Most of them pretty cheap. Animate Dead has been reprinted, so it's a good include to the deck. Like I said, we can also steal things that die on our opponent's side of the battlefield, so why not get some extra advantage there? With all the combat manipulation happening, things are bound to come at our face eventually, so let's go ahead and make sure they run through the threats and Rattlesnake effects we have in the lava fields. A few of the Rattlesnake effects we have in the deck include Mogmaniac. Whenever it's dealt damage, it deals that much damage to target opponent. And Emberwild Captain, whenever an opponent attacks us, if we are the Monarch, this deals damage equal to their hand size to that player. Speaking of Monarch, we have Marchesa's Decree and Revenge of the Ravens, which, whenever a creature attacks us, the attacking player loses 1 life for each creature, but Marchesa's Decree also gives us the Monarch, so extra card draw plus a little bit of extra deterrent to our opponents. We also have a little bit more protection in Urabrast the Hidden, which keeps our opponent's creatures coming into play tapped, or Kazul Tyrant of Cliffs, where they have to pay 3 mana when they attack us with a creature. If they don't, we get an ogre to help defend us. Next up we have Break the Lines, because sometimes you just really need to get that Pillow Fort guy to not have a Pillow Fort. So we're going to explore some removal options so we can keep punching face and have our opponents do it for us as well. To start us off, we have some flexible removal in Bedevil, which can destroy an artifact, a creature, or a planeswalker, and then the premier black enchantment removal, Feed the Swarm. Chaos Warp, Unstable Obelisk, and Ugin the Ineffable all help us deal with almost any permanent on the battlefield, plus Ugin gives us kind of a quasi card drawing effect and extra blockers or creatures to attack with as well. And in my opinion, no Rakdos deck is complete without Rakdos Charm. Get rid of the Reanimator player's graveyard, get rid of the token player's army by eliminating the player and dealing damage to everyone else as well, or just destroy a target artifact and get that nuisance off the battlefield. To keep our opponents on their toes though, we need to keep drawing creatures and removal spells. So Clackbridge Troll can give creatures to our opponents in case they need some defenders, maybe play some politics, but our opponents can sacrifice a creature to tap it down, we gain some life and draw a card. Azra Oddsmaker says, at the beginning of combat on your turn, discard a card and pick a creature. If you can hit with that creature, you get to draw two cards, so a little bit of a trade there, but I thought it was a nice include. Mages of the Wheel is Wheel of Fortune on a creature. Sacrifice it, and everybody draws seven cards. Read the Bones allows us to scry two and draw two cards. We do lose two life, but the card draw is totally worth it here. And last but not least, we have Xantcha's Sleeper Agent, which by itself with enough mana can win the game against one opponent for you, plus help everybody draw some cards. Again, some more politics. Also has to attack each combat if able against other opponents, but look out for Edict effects because they can wreck your day if you're wanting to use Xantcha. And that's it for this deck tech featuring Kardur the Doomscourge. Let me know what you think about it in the comments, and of course if you want to check out the deck list in its entirety, the deck list link will be posted in the description below. After playing the deck for a bit, I think just concentrating on the commander and its somewhat better super goat ability is the way to go with the deck, but again let me know your thoughts in the comments below. After this series we are off to some Time Spiraled Remastered commanders, join me for that, and until then I'll see you around and stay safe.